The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one.
The Falcons, in talking with them this week, Kirk, it's just interesting their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. And I'd be shocked if they can slow him down.
Brought down at the 24. The halfback took the pitch but couldn't find any running lane.
And there were no running lanes because this defense had so much penetration into the backfield. He would have been lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Third and 11. Ball on the 24-yard line. A little toss across the middle. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
They'll certainly need better production from this offense as the game goes on.
I'm sure the fans are thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game. Let's see if the offense can give them something else to get excited about now.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's at midfield. And he's taken down at the 43.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
Sell a run, but ends up on the ground.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
Mike seven. Come on. You gotta bring it.
Here we go.
And it's caught. Taken down at the 22-yard line.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Fires out to his wideout. They'll bring him down right around the 10-yard line.
I'm a huge fan of the play-action pass in college football because play-action, it really puts a lot of pressure on defense. The defense gets caught up and concerned about the running game, and it puts them out of position. And it makes the throwing lanes for the quarterback and the windows that he's trying to find much easier to find for a quarterback and the receivers to pick up big yards like we just saw there.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Here we go!
Looks to a receiver, touchdown! Splits the uprights with the extra point. So an 8-play, 63-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. The score now, 7-0. Mississippi State ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Mississippi State's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
He fights forward to about the 26. He
sacked on the play. Third and 11 here. Ball on their own 24. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled at the 40.
Makes the reception. Number 34 makes the tackle at the 40-yard line. First down.
And they make the stop at the 44-yard line. That reception good for around 4 yards.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up. Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
Makes a grab and steps out right away. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled right around the 40.
That's good for the 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
There's a strike complete. That's a great tackle at the 37. Tackles him hard at the 21.
First down.
It's the ninth play of the drive.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
That'll bring up second and 12.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 23. He heaves it to the end zone. Incomplete, almost picked off.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. Put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempts. The kick is up, and it's good.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
7-3, Mississippi State. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the one, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
So the sack makes this a second and long. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. They come out in a five-wide set.
Ready! Ready, team!
And he is drilled at the 46-yard line.
Mississippi
Mississippi State is up four. Quick strike and he drops it. Not a lot of offense in quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. The Bulldogs lead 7-3. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
Four down. Seven's a Mike. Mike seven.
Set. Green 19.
Motion.
Green 19.
Here's the halfback on the screen. And down he goes around the 47-yard line.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
He makes it to the 45-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
They didn't need too much on that fourth down, and the option nets the yards to move the sticks. Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43.
Set. Green 19.
Complete. He's got room. Tackle at the 38-yard line.
Number one with the tackle at the 38-yard line. That'll make it third and five.
And he's level at the 47-yard line.
Loss of 9 yards on the play. That'll make it fourth and 14.
Mississippi State is up by four. It's a short kick. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. And a quick throw. He's out to the 30. Brought down at the 36.
Number 37 makes the tackle at the 36-yard line. First down.
Just throws this one away. Second and 10. Ball on their own 36.
Tight right.
Tackle made at the 40-yard line.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
First down.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. About 5 yards on the quarterback keeper.
And
he's taken down at the 20-yard line.
That's where you fly to the ball.
Number 24 on the tackle at the 20-yard line. First down.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. The five. Touchdown, Bowling Green.
You got to give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point.
And he converts the extra point. A nice 7-play, 78-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points. So the score now, 10-7. Bowling Green gets set to kick this one away. And they can forget about returning this one. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Hey, number eight's coming. Number eight's Mike.
And he hits him hard at the 43-yard line. It out to his receiver in a hurry. He's taken down around the 49-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 46. Slings it. And he's tackled at the 39. Fires quickly to the tight end. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line. This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. Game plan is just what we've been seeing through a couple of quarters now. Give this guy the football and let him ram it down the defense's throat and just keep giving it to him until he gets tired or the defense gets tired.
Well, the offensive line, I also think, deserves a lot of credit. You know, the back is the star. He's been getting most of the yards and most of the attention, but he's not doing it alone. The offensive line's paving the way and opening this thing up, and the running back's taking advantage of it. They've had a great first half.
He's tackled at the 23. Bowling Green is up a field goal. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 23. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And he's immediately tackled. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Bowling Green's going to take their first time out of the half. He's under some heat. Just throws this one away. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 40.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at about the 47-yard line. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball, and a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
What was that?
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
No, it's a green nine.
Right around the 28-yard line.
Points were very hard to come by in those first two quarters. They'll head to the locker room. The Falcons with a 3-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnover. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollock can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kurt, ready for the second half.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin, and we got a tight game here. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Hands it to the back. Loss of one there for the halfback.
That is a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
Seven's a Mike. Mike seven.
He makes it to the 25-yard line.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
That's a gain of two on the play.
Man left.
That'll bring up third and eight.
Three down. Mike seven.
Check. Right in.
That close to being intercepted.
Number 27, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and eight.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick.
He fields the punt at the 20, gets to about the 34-yard line.
We're about set to start things up again. Bowling Green holds a field goal lead.
I love the toughness here by this quarterback, sitting in into the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him.
Got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Gives it up the gut, and they'll get him in the backfield.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
It's third and 15. Ball on the 29-yard line. There's a strike complete, and he's tackled right away.
That makes it first and 10.
Throws complete. He's hit right away.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That makes it second and 6.
Throws it in a hurry. He gets 4, maybe 5 yards on the counter.
That's good for 5 yards. That brings him 2nd and 5.
Gets it out complete again to his tight end. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a 1st and goal.
That makes it 1st and goal.
Bowling Green has a 3-point lead. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown.
So this entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 6. He's out to the 30. He gets hit out of bounds at the 34-yard line. The Falcons continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Set, blue 14, cut.
He scrambled. Inside the 30, finds the junior. What a play, and that'll set up a 1st and goal. And the receiver shows us why he's considered one of the fastest on the team.
You know, you often hear the term deceptive speed and how certain players have it, but I'll tell you what, there's nothing deceptive about this guy's speed. He can flat out fly.
He makes it to the 9. Him down for a loss.
It's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That makes it 30.
Third down now and goal to go. Ball on the 12.
Mike 7. Ready. Check. Hammerhead.
He's going left. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. He gets it up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Mississippi State ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting 4th quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you.
Quick throw, picked off. Tackle at about the 23-yard line.
Not only did he demonstrate his leaping ability, but he also has the hands to be able to pull the ball in. Great job.
From the 23-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 13-yard line.
The defender can only pick one player, and this time, he can't pick the wrong guy.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And they can forget about returning this one. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Quick strike and he drops it.
Number nine, the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Nice run up the middle.
With the tackle. Call it a gain of 5 yards.
Man,
third
four
down.
Third
down.
Hey, no, look, we got Mike 50. Mike 50. Huh? Go. 28, 28. Go. Go. Go.
He's to the 40. Tackle made at the 40-yard line.
Number 12 makes the tackle at the 40-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Down at about the 49.
That's good for a game. First down.
Check.
And he's taken down right around the 40.
That brings him second and one.
Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down at the 28.
Number two brings him down at the 28-yard line. That brings him second and five.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Get to that quickly. They'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. So at the end of three, good game here, 17-17.
all tied up, and we head to the all-important fourth quarter. Kicks away, and it's good.
And with that, all the pressure now shifts back to the other side. That's what a good kicker can do.
They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Time's running short here, so let's see what plays out.
We're starting to get to crunch time here, Brad, in this football game. With this offense down by a field goal late in the game, at the very least, they've got to be thinking about a field goal to tie it. If they get a shot to get a touchdown to take the lead, obviously that would be even better.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut. And he's tackled at about the 41. The stop around the 49-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
Tackle around the 33-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Three down, three down. Mike seven. Mike seven.
He fights forward to about the 30. From the 30-yard line. First down. Complete over the middle, and he's hit immediately.
That'll make it second and inches.
Ready, 388.
What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
Second and goal.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Tackle at the 1 yard line. Just under three to go in regulation. Touchdown! And now they're winning this ball game. And he tacks on the extra point. Mississippi State kicks this one off. Turn it from the three. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. Bowling Green's given them all they can handle today, and they're still not done.
Yeah, let's remember, they were a heavy underdog coming into this game, and here they are, under 3 minutes to go, with the football, a chance to put a drive together, and who knows, maybe they can take the lead.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Tackle made at the 33-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Mike 50! Mike 50!
Catches it, and he's punished.
Gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
Four down, four down. Here we go. Watch 7. Watch
his man. First down. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
First down.
Just throws this one away. From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Throws a strike over the middle. They'll spread the field with five wide. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Number 37 with the tackle at the 36-yard line.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. And he's got his receiver. It's the sophomore.
That's a deep 10. That'll bring up third and inches.
Watch seven. Watch seven. Watch seven. Hey, Mike's 50.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Steps out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Fires it out.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Zips it to the back. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That's a deep nine on the play. That makes it first and goal.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. This is the 13th play of this drive. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And he is drilled at the 16. Big third and goal. Can the defense stop him? Rifles this one out to the left.
Number 17, the intended receiver on the play. That brings us fourth and goal.
Three down.
This is it. They've got to get it in the end zone. They get the sack, and they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? He gets out to about the 22-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. From their own 22-yard line, second down. He gets to about the 31-yard line. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. The Falcons are going to call their second timeout. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Defense has got to do a better job of being more aggressive. You know, this offense doesn't seem to be in much of a hurry. They're working the clock. You know the chances are they're going to run the football. That allows the defense to pin their ears back and get aggressive. And it really comes down to the defensive linemen holding up against the offensive line and the linebackers and safeties crashing downhill and making plays against the run game.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. 24-20, Mississippi State. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nussle saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.